Dear family of God, today we come to the 17th question of the Westminster Shorter Catechism. Into what estate did the fall bring mankind? The answer, the fall brought mankind into an estate of sin and misery. Romans 5, verse 12, therefore just as sin came into the world through one man, and death through sin, and so death spread to all men because all sinned. Galatians 3, verse 10, for all who rely on works of the law are under a curse, for it is written, cursed be everyone who does not abide by all things written in the book of the law and do them. I was in my 40s when my father and then mother died, 6 years apart. My family was dealing with their decline from February into April of each year, and then they both died in early April, both around Easter Sunday. My family has endured the loss of parents, grandparents, a brother, cousins, and other close friends. But despite these tragedies, our experiences are not unique. Death and disease come to every family, and all of us have or will have painful stories that daily weigh heavily on our hearts and minds. And while it's not always easy to be honest, and I want to be encouraging, our stories all have a similar theme because we all are sons of Adam, in whom we all died because we all sinned in him and fell into a state of sin and misery with him. As a pastor, having served now in two churches for over two decades, I have witnessed many deaths and have held the hands of countless men and women, boys and girls, who are themselves suffering from some sort of disease or dealing with the health or death of a loved one. Death and disease are part of life. In one way or another, we are all faced with death and disease every day that we live. Even though people today are isolated more than ever from real community and more insulated by a facade of creature comforts, we cannot escape the harsh realities of death and disease around us. We might be tempted to try to run from death and hide from disease while striving with all of our might never to think about such matters. Yet if we do, we avoid real issues dealing with the misery that came with the fall of Adam. Unless the Lord returns first, we will all die. How we die and how we cope with the daily realities of death and disease reflect our hope and courage in the Lord himself. Will we stand and shake our fist at God in bitter anger? Or will we kneel in prayer and in humble dependence on our Lord and on the promises of the gospel in Jesus Christ? Back to the Shorter Catechism. We have already talked about Adam's federal headship over the human race, how when Adam fell, we all fell with him. Sin entered into God's most precious creation, and instead of bringing joy and delight to the Creator and creature, we now face the burden of sin and misery around us. Preparing us to embrace the gospel, this condition of misery is evident. We were designed to be at peace and fellowship with God, yet we rebelled against God and instead now face the misery of not having fellowship with our Creator. We were designed to be at peace and in fellowship with our fellow man, yet we rebelled against that design, and now there is murder, harm, insult, slander. We were designed to be at peace with the natural world around us, yet we rebelled against that design, and now there is a plunder of natural resources. There's a destruction of the created world around us, and we live in fear of what the elements may do to us at any given moment. There is misery everywhere around us as we look and everywhere we turn, dear family of God. And it all stems from sin. It's all a result of the fall of Adam and our rebellion against God. We live in a state of misery. Now, in coming devotionals, the Catechism will examine even more closely the estate of sin and the estate of misery, particularly the eternal effects of fallen from our original design. Today, we see how our fallen nature from our original state has had very real consequences, not only eternally, but also in the here and now in this life. However, take courage. The scripture will bring us great hope, for the second Adam has indeed come, and by one work of righteousness, the Savior who dies upon the cross, who is risen indeed again, he will bring life and justification for all of God's people who trust in him. Dear family, let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, the Word of God takes us very directly to the misery of the fallen world around us. Father, we thank you that we may have hope in Jesus Christ, hope of eternal life. So, Father, help us to take courage this day. It's in Christ's name that we pray. Amen. Dear family of God, may the Lord keep us and bless us this day and forevermore. Amen.